start my messages off with something a little lighthearted. And I heard about this little old lady who visited a church one Sunday morning. Came through those back doors, and the good welcoming ushers quickly approached her and welcomed her to the church service that morning and asked her where she would like to sit that Sunday morning. She told them, "Well, I'd like to sit in the very front row." The usher said, "Oh, no, 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 ma'am. Believe me, trust me, you do not want to sit in the front row. Our pastor is so boring. He'll put you to sleep. He is so dull." The old lady was so offended. She said, "Sir, do you know who I am?" He said, "No, I am the pastor's mother." The usher said, "Ma'am, do you know who I am?" She said, "No." He said, "Thank God." Grace and peace to you from God the Father, and from our Lord and from our Savior Jesus, who is the Christ. Amen. Being with other people is hard, isn't it? I mean, other people, they just don't do the right thing. I mean, if everybody else could get on the same page, the same program, life would be so much easier. Other people are dumb. You know, why don't they think like we do? Being with other people. This morning, I want to talk to you about that. Being with other people. And if you belong to this church, you know that being with other people sometimes is hard. And sometimes we disagree. And we just want to shake them until they can see things the way that we do. This morning, we're about, 35 hours into a government shutdown. Now, believe it or not, I didn't have inside sources. President Trump didn't call me up to make sure that I had this sermon ready. But it's all kind of lined up. 35 hours into yet another government shutdown. And I'm hearing about it, I'm listening to it, and I was glued to the TV set Friday night. I knew this was coming, so I turned it on to the cable news. And there they are, this group of 100 men and women, our U.S. senators. And they're describing it almost play by play. There's Mitch McConnell, you know, he's sitting there holding court as all these other senators gather around him. And there's Chuck Schumer, he's got another little corner. And they're going back and forth, and there's all this intrigue. Will they strike a deal before the clock chimes? Yet another government shutdown. And depending where you are on the political spectrum, you're either saying, "Why can't those Democrats think like I do?" Or if you're on the other side, "Why can't those Republicans think like I do?" Both sides pointing fingers at one another. Both sides have their shoes dug into the sand. They are not going to budge. And I honestly don't know how long this shutdown is going to take place, but I know real people are being impacted by this. My neighbor works for the government, and he doesn't know how long he's got on their slush fund. Could be a week, could be 2 weeks before he can't go to work anymore. What's that? Right here. People are impacted by that. I know this is a part of our lives. What does God have to say about this stuff? Our readings for this morning are really interesting. The first reading takes place as the Israelites are coming into the Promised Land. They have this brand new, beautiful nation carved out by God. And when they first get there, they don't really see a whole lot of sense raising up a king or elected leader. The first 100 years or so that the Israelites are in the Promised Land, there's these kind of smaller leaders that just rise up kind of organically. They're called judges. And there's people like Deborah and Samson, these judges who are quasi-military leaders, quasi-moral teachers, and quasi-kind of kings, but they're not ultimate kings, step up and lead the people forward. This morning, we read about Samuel, the prophet Samuel, and he is a great leader. He wasn't a king, but he had a very close connection with God. And he had this way of listening to the people's complaints, kind of cycling through them and then giving them a decision. But Samuel's sons were not good prophets. Samuel's sons were corrupt. They are rotten. They are wicked. And so the people of Israel are looking at Samuel and they realize he's getting older. His days are numbered. And they ask him, beg him, give us a king. All these other nations have a king. We want to be like them, like the Amalekites. We want to be like the Jebusites. We want to be like the Canaanites. All these other nations have a king lifted up. Give us a king. And so they are given a king. And if you're doing this 90-day Bible study with me, you're about to find out this was a bad route to go down. This was a bad rabbit hole to go down into. We have Saul, we have David, then we have Solomon, but from there it just gets to be a disaster. King after king are corrupt. King after king do terrible things for the people, and it turns into a disaster. Now, our New Testament reading for this morning kind of paints it from a different picture. If you are a Democrat, I'm guessing you didn't like our second reading this morning. To respect and to listen to our authorities. As opposed to if you're a Republican, I would guess that you wouldn't like this reading if you go back 5 years. We as Americans right now are so divided when it comes to politics that if our guy is in charge, we want to lift him up. But if the other side is in charge, you know what we do? Tear them down. Every single small thing, we rip them smithereens. Men and women of Christ, we can't be like this. We can't be so divided that there's nothing that the other side can say, want to do. We cannot agree upon. God's plan for how we are to govern ourselves doesn't include a king, although I don't think that's inherently wrong. Doesn't include, you know, any other form of government. God doesn't tell us that you have to live by democracy. What God is concerned about is how we live our lives, how we treat one another. Whether you're wearing the donkey hat or the elephant hat, we're all brothers and sisters in Christ in this world together. It starts right here. It starts in our own communities. The people in Washington are looking at our communities and then thinking, taking their cues from us. So I ask you this morning, I beg you this morning, if you are so encamped in your political views, open your heart a little bit. Open your minds a little bit. Be forgiving. Be humble. Be willing to listen to the other side. God has put these people in our lives to help us, to lead us. And so we are asked, we are told to pray for them. Because when they do well, we do well. This morning, follow them. Follow a life filled of humbleness, a life filled of lifting up these people in our thoughts and our prayers, because they are sent by God for us. Amen?